Que pasa, sapa, say what they do. Now, people, when you think about that incident that took place maybe 48 hours ago, I am speaking about the little Pie Pie in a Swallowfield as it pertains to reputed gangster Richie Poe, Kevin Tisdale, Tyndale, whatever his name is. Now, people, based on the information or based on facts, it is obvious that the spotter lion them spot him out. I am speaking about in Papine. And they trail him on a bike pan a yenging all the way to Swallowfield. 66 Swallowfield Avenue. Sorry, not Swallowfield Avenue. Old Hope Road to be specific. In a Swallowfield. Now, people, when you look at the reputation of someone such as Richie Poe, and we wonder how he got to this stage, people, is it karma? Is it coincidence? Or is it the fact that justice is finally served? Because, people, the truth and the fact is that when we look at the case as it pertains to Mr. Tyndale, Richie Poe, we have to wonder what is he still doing on the street. So, people, here are the facts. In 2002, he was charged for a shooting of a businessman in a Papine. And, people, he was charged for a shooting with intent, wounding with intent, illegal possession of a fire piece and also ammunition. And he was convicted back in 2005. Now, people, at this conviction, he was given 3 30-year sentences. So, people, we are talking about 90 years. Now, people, it was run concurrently. That means that he is only going to serve 30 years, whatever percentage of that 30 years that he is supposed to serve. And in most cases, it is 50%. I am not an expert on it, but based on information that I have. Now, people, when we think about the facts of the reputation of Richie Poe and the fact that he was a part of the notorious Gideon Warriors from in Augustown, Papine era. Now, when we look at the history of this gang, which was run by, we are speaking about, he was a part of Joel Andem's gang, and then him split, and then he was doing his own thing. He was a leader of his own gang. So, people, we are speaking about at least two occasions when this man was basically in all sorts of gang activity. We are speaking about some notorious gang. And if we know anything about the history of Augustown, we should say Augustown basically become quiet after a little while. However, Augustown was one of the deadliest places in Jamaica, and people, it is because of Joel and them, and also Richie Poe. Now, people, like I said, he was sentenced to 30 years, so we would have expected that he would have done at least 15 years. So therefore, him get sentenced in a 2005, and he came out 2018. So we're at 2021 right now, so we're talking about 2 to 3 years now. Now, when he came out, there was no kind of alert. Nobody was notified. I am speaking about the victim. I am speaking about the businessman in which he robbed in a Papine. So, therefore, he came out under the quiet. Nobody knew. Nobody knew anything. So, what this shows you is that, based on his reputation, when they did the pre-sentence report, first thing first, how is it that he got a minimal sentence? Now, people, don't get it twisted. Don't get it misconstrued. He was never charged for any sort of slap away. Even though the law know, even though the system know that he was a part or he was suspected in a lot of those slap away. And people, I am speaking about many. May I talk about more than 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? May I talk about X amount? May I talk about some sort of S-E-R-I-A-L tendency? Point blank and period. So anyways, he got 30 years to run concurrently. That means that him only going to do the 30. He is going to do his percentage of the 30. So therefore, people, it shows you that whenever they did that pre-sentence report, based on his reputation, they gave him a minimal sentence. Now, I know that you're going to say that, listen, 30 years is a whole lot of time, especially in Jamaica, and especially the fact that they gave him 3 30-year years running concurrently. Okay, fine. Now, people, we have to wonder, Did he get some sort of appeal? Did he get some sort of sentence reduction wherein he came out after 13 years? So people, we are talking about 2015 to 2018. So people, he did less than 50% if you are speaking about the 30 years. If we are talking about the 90 years, he did less than 17% of that time. Now people, which kind of parole board would have paroled a person like this? Because based on information that I have, he was out on parole. So therefore, the parole board granted him some sort of parole after 13 years. Now people, let me ask you a question. If Jamaica is very serious about crime, how would they parole somebody like this with his reputation, with whatever he was charged with? And people like me say, the person did not die that he caught up. However, his intention was still there. The person was just lucky. So basically, may I say, it could have easily been robbery and also slap away. Now, when we think about the system, we see that in Jamaica, there is some sort of body club. That means that the lawyer, the DEA, the judge, they know each other. And whenever the lawyer takes a client to court, he is going to get some sort of preferential treatment. And people, in this case, it is obvious that this person got some sort of preferential treatment. Now people, let me ask you a question. If Jamaica is really serious and want to clamp down on the crime, why would they allow this person to be out? Why wouldn't they give some sort of alert and make the Pope of them know, say, listen, this man is all over the place. This man is a violence producer. This man has a reputation of all sorts of things in Jamaica, the worst of the worst. However, he is out and he is flying under the radar. Because people, before 48 hours ago, I am sure that other than the person living where the neighborhood that he lived, nobody knew. Me, I talk about law enforcement. Me, I talk about Popo. Except for the one them that are getting paid under the table. Except for the judges. Except for the parole board. Except for the lawyers that are basically the beneficiary of crime in Jamaica. Because people, the truth and the facts that, and people, the lawyers are just doing their job. However, they are the ones that are the beneficiary to a lot of the crimes that are being perpetuated in Jamaica. Point blank and period. Now, people, when we look at the coincidence of what happened and why he got and why he deserved exactly everything that he got. In 2002, like I said, he was charged, he was convicted for the piper we attacked with a robbery and shoot up of a businessman. In 2021, 48 hours ago to be specific, he was trailed from Papine and people, he ended up in a place called Swallowfield. May I talk about 66 Old Hope Road, 66 Lane to be specific, and people, if you remember, I was the one that broke that news. Now people, when we look at the fact that based on information on the street, it is said that he is the one that is causing all sorts of ruption between top and bottom Swallowfield. And people, if you remember, I did a review about a couple of years ago. No, sorry. Probably about a year ago, where I said that an incident took place in a Swallowfield on Stanton Terrace, I think it is, wherein some man in a little hatchback, a white hatchback, blaze up some people in a wholesale. And people, when they were coming out, they also blaze up a old man. And then fast forward maybe about a month ago, I also did a next story where I said that those suspects are those persons that are suspected in that corner. They were also taken out from some bike from some set of man. So people, based on information that I have, it is said that this man we are speaking about, Richie Poe, he is the one that is causing all eruption in a top and bottom Swallowfield. He is the one that is splitting up everything. So therefore, that is why we see all sorts of violence. And people, remember, this is my disclaimer once again. When it comes to word on the street, it is not usually 100%. However, wherever there is smoke, there is fire. And people, the truth and the facts that, like I said, everywhere that this man goes, there is all sorts of chaos and catastrophe. And people, we saw that they wanted him. However, he was the one that also got caught up. However, five other persons and one other person fell out. One other person did not make it. He was taken to the place of recovery. And people, when I did this story first thing first, I said that he was also gone. Because people, if you know anything about me, I always come with the videos. I always come with the pictures. And I showed you the persons in my group. I showed you the picture of him lying at the back of the poor Jeep. And people, he was out. His eyes was rolling all over the place. Now people, when I do these things, people always say, yeah, but he not gone there, Ray Lele. However, people, the latest news, he was gone. He was in critical. However, people, final conclusion, he is gone. So people, the end story is still the same. They took him out. Now, when we think about the fact that a purse like this was in, laying in at the popo Jeep, I turn over and he went to the place of recovery and people, like I said, he was in critical. So therefore, even when somebody basically his heart is barely beating, even when there's a slight pulse, he cannot be pronounced. We are speaking about DEAD and arrival. However, people, we know that the condition that he was in, based on information that I got, he was barely alive. He was basically caught up in the neck and up in the upper torso. I talk about in the chest. Some people, you know that whenever you get any sort of thing like that, more than likely you are not going to make it. And people, I was also told that he tried to run for his life. Some people, it only shows you that these gangsters, whenever anything happen, more than likely they are going to be the ones that are going to survive. However, people, in this case, we see that it was the opposite reaction. Point blank and period. So people, at the end of the day, the moral of the story is this. He lived by the GUN and he was taken out by the GUN. And people, it could only end up one way. We are speaking about, well, not one way. It could have only ended up in a two way. Back to the big yard or back to the DEAD yard. Point blank and period. So people, all I got to say, happy riddance. We take one of the persons that is not basically supposed to be free off of the street. And people, we put him in a place that he is no longer coming back. Point blank and period. So anyways, people, that is my views on the whole thing as it pertains to that. And like me say, it is just my views and opinion. It is not the gospel. Your views and opinion can be respectfully different from mine. But let me know what you think in the comment section.